Perry Township Schools, where lifelong learning is inspired.
Hi there, this is Ms. Four, and I serve as the media specialist at Southport High School, and today we're going to look into how to make a collection in Destiny. You'll need to start off on the Perry Township Resource Portal, and this is the site where you can access a variety of different digital tools. On the right-hand side, we want to scroll down to school libraries under Quick Links. From here, you're going to choose your school. For me, I'm going to use Southport High School. And then it's going to open Destiny Discover. And this is the catalog where you can access all of the different materials that are available in your school library. Once you get to this page, you're going to go to the upper right-hand corner and log in. And you'll just log in with your Google account. This works for teachers and students. I want to use my perryschools.org email. And this is where I can then access my personal Destiny account so I could look at books I have checked out as well as other things. For collections today, I want to go to the upper left-hand corner, this drop-down menu, and go to collections. This is where you can see all of the different collections that are available to you and your school if they're made public or within your building. For me, I see the three collections that my media specialist has made for me, as well as public collections available in Perry Township Schools. If I was an educator who wanted to create a collection for my students, I would want to go up to private because these are my personal collections that I have created, hence your created collections. In the lower right-hand corner, you'll see this plus button. Go ahead and click it. And for today, we're going to create a test collection just to show you what it looks like. So I'm going to label it test collection. And description, it's just going to be a collection for e-learning tutorial video. For now, the visibility will remain private until you start sharing it, which means once you start sharing it, then anybody at your school or in the district can see it. You can also get the setting changed when you contact your media specialist. I'm going to click next. And then I can select my grades and my subjects. So for today, I'm going to work on a unit for ninth grade, and I'm going to work on it for an English class. So those are the things I'm going to select. This will help curate content related to that area as well as that level. So if you wanted to do something larger like multiple grade levels, for me, I'm a high school, so I could do 9 through 12, or I could pick something more broad for different subjects. But I'm going to click next. And this is where you can kind of personalize it. So I'm gonna select green and I can select a photo and then I'm gonna hit create. So this is sort of the template of what it looks like. So you'll see that the features that I picked are on the left-hand side. And then I can go ahead and start adding items. Now, something that is a misconception is that I can actually add more than just books. So if my unit is related to Romeo and Juliet, I can add URLs, I can add playlists, I can also upload notes, files, and import other collections. So if you wanted to contact your media specialist and ask them to create a book recommendation list after somebody's read Romeo and Juliet or Romeo and Juliet really likes, you could then add that collection to your collection. So for now, I found this resource on teachingbooks.net about Romeo and Juliet. So I'm going to copy the URL. And I'm going to paste it so I can add it to my collection. And you'll see that it pops up. You'll see that it also pops up with subjects related to that collection, and they also kind of correlate to what I've created as well. So I can add URLs as well as upload files, but what about the resources that are available through my school library? If I'm doing a Romeo and Juliet lesson, I could then also just do a generic search of my terms. So Romeo and Juliet, right away, default is books, and I see that there is an unlimited copy of an ebook of Romeo and Juliet. If this is something that I'm like, this is what I want, I can then also go over on the right-hand side to add to collection. And it will drop down, and we created a test collection, and I can add it to test collection. If I also want to import other collections, I've got options that have been created by other users that are public. I also have websites, so if I've seen something that I think will work for my students, especially during this time of e-learning, like this study guide, I could favorite or I can add it to a collection. You also have databases, so if you wanted to do research, you also have open educational resources. If you aren't familiar with these, this is something you could dive into later, but for now, we're gonna go ahead and just go back to our collection. So after I've added a few things, I go back to my collections page, and you'll see, once it pops up, that I've created a collection that I can then start sharing with my students. Once you've got it, you can go up to this little share button, and I can change the viewing so anybody with a link can view or edit. So if you have students who you just want this to be a resource where they kind of refer to, they can view it. And you can copy the link and email it to them, or you can post it in Classroom. You can also, if you're working with multiple teachers in the same content area, you can then add them to your collection so that they can also start contributing.
This resource was brought to you by the school librarians of Perry Township Schools.